tempted to say, give me patience. Right? Now, have you heard that said, give me patience? You people say that? Maybe it's a Welsh thing, is it?
No.
No, it's general, is it, around the world?
It's normally stronger words.
Well, is it, yeah, give me patience. It often indicates a bad attitude. But actually, it might be taken to indicate pretty good theology. Because if we have to rely on patience coming from within ourselves some days, that's not going to be, it's not going to work. And actually, Scripture's teaching us that patience is a fruit of the Spirit, and it comes from God. See, you can tell people to be patient as much as you like, without effect. It's one of those things like, calm down, dear. It's going to have the opposite effect, isn't it? Be patient. It's not going to work. It's going to have the opposite effect. Now, being patient, like being calm and a host of other things, it might be good to be, but it's unlikely to get easier by having somebody tell you to do it. And you tell yourself you should be patient. Because God is gloriously patient with you, but this thrashing yourself over the matter won't make it any easier either. It's a leading characteristic of our God. He's got it. Mm-hmm. And he gives it. He's got it. He is patient as a leading characteristic of who he is. His patience with his people is beyond legendary. But it doesn't come easily at all to our human fallen nature, does it? It's not natural to us, it's natural to him. So for Christians then, it grows on Christians as the fruit of the Spirit, who, being God, being gracious, possesses it naturally, and he grows it on those who are grafted into his vine. Here's how it works for us. It's as we're grafted into him, as we draw on him, as we live our lives with him, that we grow in patience. You're not an air plant. See those wires on the screen, on that picky on the screen? Those wires have got plants growing on them. Would you believe that?
I thought it was somebody being mug spreading.
Yeah, it's come straight out of the mug spreader and hit the wire because he hasn't controlled the lid on the hydronics. Yeah. Absolutely, looks like he's flung them high. But actually what you've got is a plant that's got no roots in soil. It's in the air. You will not suck this patience out of the air around you, folks. It doesn't live there. You're not an air plant. You're rooted because you're grafted into a vine. And you're drawing on that vine which has patience in himself. And it's as we draw on him, Christian's patience grows rooted in God, buffeted by its environment, but strengthened to deal with that patiently as we draw on our rootstock for strength. It's growing in drawing strength and leadership from God in a number of ways in response to tests of that patience. Waiting patiently, drawing on the rootstock, on the vision of our God, the strength.